start starting up. Go go gadget DLC. Oh, Luna Lockhart! Wow. Yeah, I guess that in my mind, I was completely thinking that that was Lovegood as well. I don't know. I'm pretty sure I even said Lockhart. I did. Did I say Lockhart? I may have said Luna Lovegood. Apologies if I ever say Luna Lovegood. That is the immediate name that I think of after Luna. Alright, so I've played Phenom's Fox a couple of times now. I think he's beaten me every time. So one of the matchups that I probably need to be working on more. Let's get into it and see what I do wrong. Audio a little bit higher. So major, oh man, I have to remember my hotkeys. I do it? Oh, that's two. Okay, shift is about like so, a lot of Fox's movement is either going to be the way that he like interacts in neutral. It's going to be quick dash attacks like this that control space forward, or by jumping in and coming down with like neutral air or down air or crossing up with back air. And it's really, really difficult to stop him from doing that because his aerial mobility is really good, and his hitboxes are really good, and they're really safe on landing. Some of the thoughts on this matchup and Guardian. This matchup, it's kind of strange. I'm not sure if I like it or not. I haven't played enough Fox. The fact that he's so fast and so safe makes my life difficult. I don't know if it's necessarily making Roy difficult, because I'm used to like dancing around people and spacing things well, and Fox doesn't really let you do that because he's extremely quick and super slippery, and he converts into a lot of damage whenever he does actually hit you. A lot of the times, so he's pretty low risk, pretty high reward, especially for being able to move around as fast as he does. I think walling him out is like a viable option. It's just pretty difficult. Yeah, see, dropping in with a neutral air like that. Although interesting to note that neutral air didn't actually combo. I got a little impatient and tried to punish the shield, the jab. I may have been expecting an up tilt. Dancing around a little bit. So yeah, this is the thing. Since Fox is pretty safe after landing with an attack on your shield, what you should actually be doing most of the time is shielding the attack on the way down, and then shielding his next attack as well, and then trying to retaliate, because you're not going to be able to fit an attack in between the dropping and the second attack. So, but like jabs and up tilt aren't actually unpunishable. You can punish them even if he's behind you. It's kind of weird, but oh yeah, I think Roy does juggle Fox relatively easily. I find it easier to juggle characters like Luigi, honestly, just because forward throw eats them alive. But that may just be an experience on my part, since I need to figure out what percents and what exactly Roy can get off of down throw against the faster falling characters. I know Roy can get guaranteed forward throw to double edge dance against Fox, but I'm sure there are lots of percents where it's more efficient to be going for down throw stuff. And that's really, really big for Phenom. So yeah, I see they're getting a little bit of momentum. So this is a sort of a principle that I like telling people a lot, is whenever you're in this sort of position where you're above the stage and your opponent has momentum, it's best, like in this position, you can drop and go for the stage or drop and like go for aerials, but that's actually really, really unsafe. Landing, especially in this game in Smash 4, can be really, really difficult. So instead, it's better just to go to the ledge. The ledge is a safe spot. This is good. This is bad. In almost all situations. There are some situations where you can try and sneak stuff in, but understand that if you do try to go for that, then you'll be putting the risk reward not in your favor. Interesting that neutral A didn't get up tilted out of shield. tactical note there. Pretty good coverage on the... So yeah, as End Guardian was saying, kind of walling out here, since he has... I've got him cornered, so I've got all this center stage, and he doesn't have much room to move around. So rather than try and push in and actually attack him, I'm just trying to control this part of the stage. So a lot of the time, foxes will get impatient and try to like side B in to simultaneously try and get things going and get through this situation. So yeah, setting up the Nairs to beat side B and approach. Pretty good in that situation. I think this is something I need to work on more, is figuring out how to beat the side B to the ledge. In this situation, there probably wasn't much I could have done about it, since it was so fast he just instantly dropped and then zapped out. But, yeah, I think this is something I'll need to look out for, figuring out how I can do things to kill him when he tries to do this. So that's the thing we'll look out for today. So whenever I'm at about 40% dash tech combo, or the Nair combos in the dash tech. Yeah, so that time he was a little bit more patient, and so kind of a similar spot where I have control of center stage, but he did have the platform to cover him to make him the full jump stuff a little bit more safe. Almost got that board smash. See, the neutral B actually stalls Roy's momentum a little bit in the air. So that's one tricky way you can try and fake your opponent out on the way down. Didn't really work in this situation. Super low percent kill. He must have been. He's probably still holding down to try and get the ledge. But, yeah, this is a pretty scary situation for him, because, well, he did have his double jump. Well, he probably should have just double jumped up, but that puts him in a kind of risky spot where he has to land on stage whenever I've got control of things. He could air dodge right here, but then again, that puts him, he's probably going to air dodge below the ledge and have to use his double jump down there, or up B, which is also kind of scary. So he was probably trying to just slip to the ledge, which in this situation, not the best idea. He probably just looked like he got caught off guard by the back air. He wasn't ready for it. And Fox is super, super light. So this is a pretty comfortable lead. I haven't landed any grabs on him. That's something to note. I haven't grabbed him at all. Don't know if that's a good thing, or well, that might be a bad thing. I think Fox is a character Roy should be getting a lot of damage against off of throws. Okay, yeah, you see again, I was trying to... but this is another situation where the knockback angle is sending him perfectly so that he can side B almost instantly out of hitstone, which... I don't know if Roy will be able to cover. I might be able to cover the two-frame vulnerability from the ledge. But even then, that'd be kind of hard to get here. Get there and punish it in time. Yes, using the fair is to shift momentum. Honestly, I'm not even sure if that works in this game. It worked in Brawl, though, and... I'm not sure if it works. It does put you out of tumble faster. So I guess it does technically give you better air control immediately. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure it is actually beneficial, but mostly I've been doing it because it's just a thing that's automatically the thing you want to do in other Smash games. If they'd spaced their side B poorly, down tilt would probably work. I think from this height, this height down tilt probably wouldn't hit him. Well, no, actually, he's kind of high. Yeah, I might have been able to hit him with down tilt. I guess it's a thing worth trying. Okay, yeah, I'll have to actually watch that video then, so I know my facts. Oh, scary. This kind of vexes me, because DI-ing this up tilt's really weird. Because it starts reverse hitting you and then pulling you back towards him. Which is very weird. I need to, like, talk to people to see if there's a way to get around that. Watch dance. Kind of surprised he didn't press a button there, but I guess he was scared of getting smashed. Oh, that could have been such a harder button. That's another thing that annoys me about boxes. It's very ambiguous which side of you he's going to be after he does dash attack. He goes so far, sometimes he crosses you up, and then you don't. I want to be able to punish it hard, like drop shield down smash or up smash actually would be probably the best choice, but it's hard to tell when that'll actually work. So that's a fairly light punish. I did put him in a pretty terrible position off stage. I'm surprised that forward air did the combo. What if I did that late? Okay, it looks like I did get the run a little bit late. I may have been able to actually combo off that. Oh, yep, and then he gets the back air. So this is actually a really close game. That hitbox, jeez. Okay, I didn't pull back far enough. It looked like I started to go out and then kind of pulled in, and that was too close to the ledge. It's still like he can still hit this space. So I either should have pulled out harder, or tried to land on the stage. I wouldn't have died to up air at this percent. And I think even back air this far in stage wouldn't have killed me. So that would have been the safer choice. So I kind of got clipped while hesitating, I suppose, in the air. Jab to up B, as Roy does, actually work. It depends on percents and the way that they DI. Like, if they DI out pretty hard, sometimes it won't work. Jordan Berg, I don't think sitting in shield against Fox is really a great idea, because he has safe shield pressure, like that makes it so he can dance around you. And if Roy had better out of shield options, I might agree. He doesn't have zero suit up B out of shield, or his jab's kind of slow. It's frame 5. 4? Frame 4? 4 or 5. I think it's 5. Yeah, and you're not ever really going to get a shield grab against Fox. Maybe at high percents, if you want to look for like F tilt out of shield, that might be a good idea. And I suppose his throws aren't as scary at high percent, so maybe at high percent, you should start looking for more shields. I'm pretty sure Fox can combo off of throws at low percents, like down throw to forward air. I guess it's something to try. I'll figure out more. So that was a pretty close game. Jab frame 5, okay. Yeah, I was thinking of Cloud Jab frame 4. Okay, yeah, jump cancel up smash is something I probably should do more against Fox, you're right. Especially at high percents. That's a good thing to make note of. Yeah, I'll have to look for that more. Versus Fox. Side B is not a very good move against Fox. Against a lot of characters, you can kind of whip it out there, and sometimes you can get away with whiffing it. But Fox dash attack just punishes that crazy. Down throw to jab isn't actually... I don't think after the down throw is true. I'm pretty sure they can get out of it. Yeah, usually I'd prefer to go for stuff like down throw, jab, jab. just to get a little bit more guaranteed damage. Yeah, you can see here that in this situation, the forward throw double-edged dance is pretty good since it puts him off stage. So I tried doing neutral air while rising to cover this space in this situation. Still doesn't get his forward beat, though. Maybe I just stay on stage and take the positioning? Oh, the combos, he's doing so much damage. I need to start teching these. Forward airs like this. It's usually fairly obvious whenever they start drifting like that so that they don't get the full hits. And this is, so for you guys talking about using double-edged dance more, this is one of the best aspects of double-edged dance, is if you're in a position like this where you've got just a bit of frame advantage on your opponent, and it's going into like the mix-up of whether or not you're going to run forward and grab them, or run forward and like do smashes and stuff, try and bait their dodge or their roll. Double-edged dance beats spot dodge, since you can do multi-hits even on whiff. No, that was weird. I got Tip Jeb here. I guess he was pretty low. Interesting. I should start baiting these air dodges. This is the third time he's air dodged after my jab. Not sure what the best punish would be.
Great character awareness. Well, these players have great character awareness. They really understand what these follow-ups are. Nice patience that we saw from Phenom. A lot of foxes in the upper. A lot of foxes get really scared in that situation, right? So they'll run off and prematurely try to get out of the corner, but Phenom just waited.
Ooh, okay, here we go. He's trying to catch the landing with up smash. Wow. I guess I didn't get the hill. No, that was definitely a hill. I guess it was just, since it was full stage, he DI'd fairly well. Okay, so from this distance, oh, I missed the back air. From this distance, it's much easier to catch him out of his IP. I went a little bit too far out for this back air. I should have. I guess just bad spacing on my part. I was trying to set up a forward air versus that dash attack, but hitbox lasts a really long time. And the weak hit does combo into up air. Good ol' up tilt coming out after that jab. Forward throw. Forward throw double edge stance to 17%. That's pretty good. Relatively good damage. Maybe I can get more off down throw. I need to experiment. Nope. So right here, as you guys may have been noticing the rest of the game, I was doing a lot of, whenever I was falling, using double edge dance B reverse to flip my momentum. So I land on the, you know, the different area to get around his chasing me whenever I'm landing. Since I was doing that a lot, I was expecting him to try and bait him. So yeah, I was expecting him to be covering that option rather than the standard option, and he didn't actually. He was just going for regular covering the normal land. So that tried to be a little bit too fancy there, and it kind of backfired. Could I have footstooled? I could have footstooled him right there, actually. Yeah, that's something to keep in mind, I suppose. Footstool him, go for the tree. Unless you're talking about whenever we were off stage. He's got a sword, he loves the juggles. He would prefer to take the stocks early by throwing them off stage and covering things like the phantasm. You set it up perfectly at the beginning of the set. It's all about that option coverage, and Sephon has done a really good job overall. Right now though, he hasn't found that opportunity to toss Phenom off, and Phenom is walking away with his set slowly but steadily. 121 on Sephon. He's desperately trying, but he okay. So this is one of the reasons why I don't like the idea of camping and shield, is because even if he can't kill me off of the throw, he still gets positioning. Enough of positioning, he can set up kills. Although I was already in a bad position there, so higher likelihood of me getting grabbed for using shield rather than just using it neutral. Let's check out, see if I can find whenever he was off stage. I might have been able to put Storm there, yeah. I was trying to back air him though. The back air definitely would have killed him, so. So. Yes, it's hard for. Well, there are a couple things that I definitely did wrong. Right here, missing the back air. That should have been a kill. I should have been in the lead. Yeah, getting hit by lots of dash techs. Dash tech is just a really, really good move. Not sure what I do about that. I guess stay more grounded, stay in shield more. Yeah, he's baiting it out. I guess the thing that I should work on is baiting out the dash tech and actually punishing it. Actually punishing it has been the hard part for me. Baiting it isn't too terribly difficult, but since he moves so weird, I need to figure out what the spacings are for when I need to up smash at a shield. I should look at the actual frame data of the dash tech itself and see how negative it is, see if I can do stuff like drop shield F tilt, drop shield down smash. I'm pretty sure side B is too slow. Even drop shield jab might be nice. So that would be a thing I need to do. I didn't up B him at all this game. That may have been because, like I've been talking about, I've been trying to up B a little less just to get used to all of Roy's other options, but I probably could have upbeat him a couple times. I wasn't even looking for it as I was going through, but that's something to keep in mind, I suppose. So yeah, then I guess those are three main points that I need to, well, yeah, three main points that I should be looking at to improve in this matchup: figuring out better ways to edgeguard him off stage, or just retain stage position if I can't edgeguard him. Punishing the dash attack with potential drop shield jabs, jump cancel up smashes, drop shield F tilt, and figuring out what I can get out of down throw. This forward throw side B is pretty good. It does, like I said, 17% from zero. But I might be able to get better from down throw. Not sure. 17 is a lot of damage, at least for Roy. So yeah, and I need to try just shielding in general. Getting up smashes out of shield. Up smash out of shield is something I haven't been very good at, so I should look into that more. Yeah, up B out of shields are good. Alright, so that's the first game I wanted to analyze. So this is from last week, playing against Hylen. Hylen had a really good run with Cloud, and of course I've been messing around with the character as well. He's a lot of fun, and I'm a big Final Fantasy VII fan. Yeah, I did really well at that last tourney, well, against Phenom. Above the tournament I played Phenom at, I got fourth, I believe, or third? Third. Third, I think it was third because that was my record so far. I'd gotten fourth before. Maybe it was fourth. I don't remember. Oh, this tournament I actually didn't do so hot. This has been my lowest placing in a while. Cloud did fairly well. I had a couple unfortunate things happen to make me lose stocks in very bad times, but. I was playing against Lightning Cam and Losers, and we started off the game, and I charged Limit Break, and he ran at me. And I canceled Limit Break and tried to do something, like forward tilt, and he forward aired me out of it. And I slid off stage and got a buffered forward air, and then just couldn't recover from that, so I died at 11%. And then, you know, proceeded to go on tilt and just lose.
Surprise, what a surprise. Blink so
So yeah, Hylen Cloud's really good stuff. Let's see. Yeah, up smash. Cloud's up smash has surprisingly low cooldown for a smash. So it's really good at covering stuff like this, and being relatively low risk while he's at it. And that low percent has, can sometimes combo. I've gotten some silly things like up smash into up smash before. One thing to note is that, so Cloud has the Ike style forward air, you know, where he just swings in front of him. But it doesn't actually cover the entire arc. It's got a blind spot above him, where it doesn't have hitboxes. Yeah, you can see the sword's going completely through him there, but it only hits, like, this far and down. So in this situation, it's better to use neutral air, which neutral air actually has, like, a full 360 degree cover, and actually has about that much range. Like, that's a huge circle. Back air, so I'm trying to set up right here for a back air, because it's one of the safest aerials Cloud can land with. I time it a little wrong though. So. The golf swing. The tiger... so yeah, you can see here, look at how much coverage this thing has. So it actually has hitboxes back here whenever it starts, and goes all the way around. There's a humongous. And up air. All of Cloud's aerials are really, really good. Throws, not so good. But this is the one thing you can do off of throws. Is you can, it's really a positional thing rather than a combo thing. So you put your opponent right here, and then they either have the option of, you know, jumping away, landing, pulling back, like going in for aerials, going in for air dodging. And since Cloud has such a huge sword, he can cover most of those things if he decides to commit to it. Thinking like, you know, like in this situation, I jump and I up air to try and cover up here. I could have jumped in neutral air to just put out hitboxes. Yeah, so despite the fact that it doesn't actually combo, it's still a fairly good positioning tool. Doesn't get huge stuff off of it, but...
if you do a rising up air from the ground, if your character's not short, like a medium normal...
I've actually got a pretty huge lead right here. Yeah, that was kind of a blow on the...
if your character's not short, like...
May have been able to catch this. I guess I was expecting him to do an aerial, so I was trying to beat the aerial out. But a little bit off space, which is pretty unfortunate. But one of the really big important parts for Cloud is using his limit breaks efficiently, because it's by far his best way to kill. That side'd be really, really safe, but it's still pretty pretty bad to have it. To whiff with it, because then you have no longer have access for it. Access to it.
Speaking of shields, I love the way that Stefan had spaced that cross slash in regards to Island Shield. Because he whiffed with it, but he was still able to
Island Shield. Bait here. So yeah, full hopped to try and bait him into stuff. I guess he was trying to land with the up. I don't know if he was trying to anti-air me here or trying to land with the up air. Landing with up air is actually really, really good. It's like one of his best aerials to do on shield and combos really well, but it's also really hard to land with that because the hitbox is where he's. Nope. Come on, DLC. Please function.
Whiffed with it, but he was still able to cover him. Shield because.
So yeah, he's the hitboxes start about right there. You see where like the green after image is. But it's only there for like a frame or two.
But he was still able to cover himself with the jabs afterwards. Taking stock one.
Man, I had a huge lead. I did lose this game, spoilers. So the whenever your opponent's around like I think the window is like 5 to 20%. If you down throw them, it sets them up for potential follow ups. It's not like guaranteed stuff, as far as I know. I believe you can sometimes air dodge out of it, sometimes jump out of it. Not completely sure yet.
Generally spacing better. It's a really, that's a really generic thing.
Nope.
Spacing better. It's a
so Cloud forward smash has a lot of end lag. It is punishable. But it's more punishable on shield than it is on whiff. So here And Cloud F Smash itself is really slow on startup. I think it's like frame 19. So forward smash is probably the wrong move to try and punish.
But there's just a lot of times where
dash attack down tilt would have been better. Oh, interesting. This time it did hit pretty far. Huh. Okay, so the arc is more like here. Maybe a little lower. You know? Strange.
Okay, because they're just spacing. They're in the right place at the right time.
Oh, that's so unfortunate. See what happened here. I guess since Cloud leans back after finishing touch. I guess finishing touch just doesn't have as much, or the cross slash doesn't have as much range as I expected it to. So I thought that would definitely hit.
Right place at the right time.
Come on, DLC.
Agreed. But whoa, falling just out before that.
I should have just F smashed him, really. The finishing touch is really, really, really punishable if he misses it.
Whoa, that's agreed. But whoa, falling just out before that final hit of that cross slash can connect. Hylen holding up this.
Yeah, approaching with down tilt is pretty good. So this up smash was kind of unsafe. Since he didn't slide back too far, since he was right at the ledge. He probably wouldn't have been able to up smash me if we had done that mid stage. So, Cloud down tilt is actually a pretty good way to punish another Cloud's recovery, since obviously Cloud doesn't snap to the ledge. That's a really good way of sliding in. Oh man, I can't believe I lose this game. I'm so slow. So trying to set up the forward air there to potentially spike him out of his B. I guess this time, since I fast-falled, that was a little bit too low. That's forward air is weird.
And it actually resulted in a punish. Stefan, I think, used the down tilt to catch him for not sweet spot. Yeah, the thing about the over limit up B, it actually auto-snaps.
Really?
The normal IB won't.
Yeah, so at this point in time, if I have limit break, I'd be able to finish him off pretty easily, so I'm trying to look for it.
Okay, so then, how do I get.
Kind of ugly. So, as I was mentioning before, the principle of going to the ledge because the ledge is safe. See that in motion right here. If I had gone to the ledge instead, like if, you can do a trick with Roy, with Cloud. Where if you're right next to the ledge, just a little bit outside of regular ledge grab range, you can up B and he'll snap right to it. Which I didn't know before this, but probably what I should have done right here. Trying to double jump for the ledge would have been kind of scary without doing that, since, you know, could potentially get caught by down tilt or dash jack and die.
I guess Hylen might have delayed it or something.
So, right here I saw he gave me the limit break, fortunately, with that blade beam. And so I was trying to up B, and I would have been fine, and I screwed up the end zone and got neutral B instead. And died at 50, because I'm a baddie.
We were talking.
So.
Oh, oops. That's okay.
Yo, what's up? I probably could have ran back to Cloud Ditto and done well, but at this point in time, I just wanted to. Oh yeah, that's a good idea, actually. A little Lockhart. Use Neon. Using this IB backwards. Okay, yes, because this IB has, like, no ending lag at all. Whenever you have limit break. So doing it like that. I've seen people do facing towards the stage in side B-ing to, like, attack people on stage. So yeah, I imagine that would work. I'll have to try that out. So yeah, I decided to switch to Roy just to try and get something out of it, get some experience other than a Cloud Ditto, and because I haven't actually played a Cloud with Roy yet, I wanted to see how it worked.
And then he accidentally used it. Wait. Okay, Sethon was recovering. He accidentally used his over limit, and then he used his neutral B, and then he was too low. Huh.
So.
Right. So
this matchup is kind of interesting because both characters are really fast.
But
both got good disjoint. Cloud's got a little bit more, obviously. Roy combos a little bit better, and his throws are scarier. He wants to stay in winner's bracket. Cloud definitely has kill power.
That's true. Oh, I think that the one thing was, the area where Cloud, I feel, suffered.
Okay, Cloud does have an answer to Nair on shield. Down tilt goes really far.
Where Cloud, I feel, suffers in comparison to Roy is how easy it is to get openings in neutral, right? But Southland was getting them regardless, and on top of that, his really, really.
Interesting the note about finishing touch is that it's got lots of hitboxes around him, and then it covers like up here too. So it comes out slow. It's like frame 16, but the coverage is pretty ginormous.
A
little bit too low percent for me to actually die though.
But he loses a bit of that punishment that he had whenever he was playing Cloud.
I thought this was gonna kill him. So I didn't bother trying to follow up. I don't know if he DI'd it correctly or I just got the tip or what.
Oh, he thought he was dead. Stefan walked away like, oh, that's it. Oh, no, he made it back.
Dakpo calling that out. I definitely expected him to be dead from that.
As far as,
he should have been dead from this.
As far as,
thought he was a little bit closer. I probably should have dropped shield, ran up smash.
As far as, the punishes and opening up in neutral,
so that was a missed opportunity there.
Just the Roy, playing Roy is just going to make him more comfortable in neutral. That's true. And he was already,
could have got that, but got the the kill off of the random up B, so that's okay. Yeah, finishing touch does have a wind box, so if he whiffs it and you're not shielding and you're a little bit close, then it is kind of difficult to punish.
Really impressive stuff. Less than 40...
Ooh, so the anyone who's watched Cloud will probably know the with down air you can set it up and then fall and fast fall and have the hitbox end just before you hit the ground, and the auto cancel window is really, really close to whenever after the hitbox ends. So he can do stuff like this where he'll hit you and then still have it auto cancel on the ground. Although he actually whiffed there.
You like Cloud? No, I do. And I like some of the things that we're seeing from Hylen.
Yeah, so that time I knew that I do. From his spacing that up tilt, that down air would miss me. I didn't quite punish.
No, I do. And I like.
Probably should have up tilted instead.
He doesn't spare a moment whenever
I tried to go for something a little a little randy here. See if I could get the air dodge or the tech. And that gets me killed.
Every single time he's able to create some separation between him and Stefan, he just charges up that limit because he knows that he wants to be able to use that full potency. We're probably going to be expecting a cross slash setup pretty soon so we can get back into the game from a damage standpoint. Yeah.
Kind of scary.
That kind of worries me about, like.
So this situation, Cloud's actually not in that bad of a position because since he has the limit break, he could potentially kill me at like 55% on this stage. So he's not really, the percent-wise, I'm in the lead, but game flow-wise, it's actually pretty even.
Is like charging the down B is going to be so important.
Ooh, okay. This is interesting to note. So he crosses up with a neutral air. I could have punished it with like drop shield something, but his up tilt catches my nair out of shield.
They're gonna wanna play.
No, kind of wastes his finishing touch there. And yeah, as you can see, I was talking about getting punished. He did actually land with something else. Like he tried to start a down air up, and it just didn't come out in time.
Yeah, he kind of fished for that. He told me that that's actually a setup where you could do an up air into a full hop finishing touch.
Oh, yeah. Up air into full hop finishing touch is actually a combo at certain percents. Probably not quite that high.
It prevented him from really executing it the way that he wanted to.
Oh, yeah. I should probably be looking to up B the down air. And countering's not a bad idea either. Countering's kind of scary because then you're, if you miss, then you're whiffing counter against Cloud and he's going to do mean things to you. Up B is a little bit harder to punish since you can drift and like go to the ledge and stuff.
That's so terrifying. Okay, first of all, that doubles. And that was.
So he takes me back to Tannin City, probably because the finishing touch will kill earlier on this stage. So yeah, this is a probably like about the percent where down throw will legitimately combo. Look at this meaty forward air. Stays out super long.
I fist bumped Trey way too hard with the hard knuckles.
Bony knuckles too.
So he's got a pretty good lead. Had a really good momentum at the beginning of the game. I don't know if forward throw down air is guaranteed on Cloud. It looked like he was DI'ing in there. So he might be a character that Roy should be down airing, down throwing instead. Oh, and I screwed up here. So I did the down air, the back air, sorry, and expected him to go for like drop shield jab or shield grab, but he just went for the raw finishing touch. So that caught the cross up, and will definitely kill at that percent.
Anyways, go ahead. But because he's winning so much in game number one from a neutral standpoint, I don't feel the swap to Roy where he basically trades punish for neutral was necessary, right? Because he, whenever it came to the neutral, he was...
I really need to be killing him. Okay, there's the blazer. Didn't quite kill him.
Here, he's in a situation where he's way behind. He doesn't have that same level of punishment that he has
for
the character
in Light Cloud. Oh, he's so... I think the limit break actually made it so that he lived. So limit break, yeah, if you guys didn't know, whenever Cloud's in limit break state, where he's got, like, the blue glowy going on, it's all glowy blue, so it changes his movements a little bit. He runs a little bit faster, and his gravity is a little bit higher. So like, he falls faster. You can tell it very obviously if you take a Cloud who is in limit and a Cloud who's not in limit, and have them both full jump at the same time. Like, you can see the one in limit obviously falls faster. So I think that, along with the fact that, like you're saying, Guardian, that the up B was a little bit staled, is the reason why he didn't die here. With a character he also DI'd cloud, pretty well. And because of that, it might be tough for him to maybe clock. Yeah, the tip back air will do the trick, though. Fortunately, finishing him off before he can use his limit.
Like Cephalon's just winning as you go. I was like, all right. But no,
okay, yeah, it looks like forward throw double edge dance doesn't work on him, so he's definitely using down throw.
But no, I understand your point. I think...
kind of gets caught by the stabs is actually a pretty bad idea most of the time, because it's super, super, super punishable. Cloud doesn't really have any hard punishes, though, outside of hitting you once super, super hard. Like, he could have F-smashed me off of that, but
he was just a little discouraged,
that's about it.
With his control of the character, and he did not want to try that again.
You know? Oh, I took so much damage right here. Why did I take so much damage?
Game one,
okay, so I got clipped by... he mashed out down tilt. I should have punished the jab with...
I think after game one,
or should have just shielded it. I should have expected him to do something there. So that's the thing Cloud likes to do.
After game one... was just a little discouraged.
Yeah, and that down tilt will combo, and that puts me in a terrible, terrible spot. You do not want to be above Cloud. Being above Cloud is a very bad place to be.
If your character control is just not what it needs to be, then I would be okay.
Oh, I'm sad this whiffed.
Not what it needs to be, then I would be okay with the switch too.
I should have. Not what it needs to be. If I had waited just a hair before starting the neutral air, and then fast fall, that would have comboed, or that would have hit, and probably gotten a combo off of it.
Okay with the switch too.
Hylen is really good at covering landings with dash grabs like this. Probably should have tried to get full edge. So, in this position, this is something I've seen other people talk about with Cloud, is whenever you have your opponent on the ledge, finishing touch will actually cover a lot of the options. Is if you roll in, finishing touch activates and it hits you. If you stand up, the finishing touch hitboxes are pretty active, so they'll often hit you. Challenging it with like ledge hop attacks is, you know, also kind of scary because it's got such a huge hitbox in the finishing touch, and I think it might have some invulnerability. I know most of Cloud's limit breaks have partial invulnerability after like 5 or so frames startup. I don't really want to jump at this point in time, because if I jump and he up airs me, I might actually just die. So what I was thinking here is that I would do get up attack and clip him and just push him off stage, push him further in stage and give me room to, you know, get my ground and do things without having to worry about getting finishing touched. But Hylen actually has that spacing down really, really, really well. So that I can get up attack. Oh no, it's not his spacing. The finishing touch actually dodged it. So yeah, if you see here, he is actually in range of my get up attack. It would have actually hit. But with the finishing touch animation, Cloud leans back and just barely moves his leg out of the way to get the finishing touch.
And Hylen taking it 2-1 over Cephalon.
So that was a really good play by him. I guess I should have neutral aired instead. I guess the neutral air might have been better in this situation. Or just jumping and dealing with the bad presence. Or ledge jump countering. Ledge jump countering would be pretty fast. Kind of heartbreaking, yeah. But I don't know. I was impressed with the spacing, so I couldn't be too sad. And you know, he was beating me a lot of the game. He did, you know, like freaking 70% pressure strings. Jump air dodge with Roy is kind of bad. If you're talking about like ledge drop jump air dodge, because Roy can't do anything before if he ledge hops and then air dodges, he can't do anything in the air. He has to hit the ground, which, yeah, pretty bad. Ledge jumping and air dodging might have worked. Yeah, I mean, that would dodge the finishing touch setup, this specifically. Kind of a bad position afterwards, but... yeah, I think either ledge jumping or ledge hopping and going for attacks. There are lots of different things I could have tried that could have potentially worked. I guess I kind of got baited. So, yeah, he was definitely in get-up attack range, which probably was his intention. It was pretty clever. Yeah, pretty good lead too. Even if I had made it back, I just need to see this again. This is so perfect. No, you can't wave dash in Smash 4. Clonk. I think with that timing, actually, I could have just done a ledge get up as well. Just stand straight up and then shield and then punish. Then black sparks. So yeah, I chose the perfectly wrong option to get myself killed. Something to think about, I guess. Okay, I think those are going to be the only ones I have time for today, since I have work to prepare for. I wish I had gotten more Cloud matches of my own, so I could go through my thought process playing the character and doing like the various things that he can set up, but unfortunately the rest of my games were in the loser's bracket for this tournament. I'll probably have more next week, though. Yeah, I think I'm going to call that a wrap for today.